everybody, and welcome to Survival Russia again. So today I want to show you a little video about hunting and trapping for survival, because I had some requests on this, and unfortunately some footage got lost, but I spent 3 days making this video, so I want to put it out anyway. Firstly, the scenario I set up for myself was the loss of navigation, complete cloud cover, so I had to wait for sun or stars or something like this, and here it can take a long time, because there's snowstorms on 12 days. So if I got stuck here, I would start hunting and trapping as soon as I knew I was in trouble. But I hope you enjoyed the video.
What do we have of kit?
Let's take a look at it. We of course have the ever-present belt rig. Here I have some optics, binoculars, and a little night vision monocle. A canvas top, poncho thing, as usual. Ground pad, the MSS again. Still with only the green bag. Now it's even warmer than last time, so water, some cooking oil, fleece, snow camo anorak. Here's an Alice pack I took off the frame, so I have a mess kit and eggs and food items and so on. So basically just what a sensible, prepared person would have on a trip in an environment like this.
So down there is a camp. It's gonna be our hunting position and our shelter.
We're sitting and looking straight at this tree line there. We have a good view out on the field. I have some kind of a view down there. I know this field pretty well, and I also know that animals are certainly not standing in line just to jump out in front of a shotgun barrel or something. Yeah, the reality of survival. Just go out and hunt, just put some traps and everything is fine. It's very easy to say on a video. And it's of course very easy to make on a video if you have all the time in the world and you edit this and this and that. But random location, random day. Now is the time you're in trouble, what are you gonna do? That's a different matter. In an emergency, what would the strategy for hunting be? Would you try and travel around? Would you hunt from a fixed position like this? What's the right choice? It's choices, 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 and is it the right ones? That's a question. But if I was about to get anything out of hunting for survival this evening and not tomorrow morning, I should not be talking right now. I cannot even make a fire or anything. So that was the first day and nothing happened, of course. So according to plan, I changed my tactics a little bit and I made 3 different hunting positions that I could rotate between. So what we're gonna take a look at now is setting the traps. Then we're gonna look at the hunting positions and the area, and then we're gonna go back to when I'm checking the traps. But firstly, I want to show you the snares. Because it's actually legal to snare here. This is a possibles bag from my survival belt rig, and there's a pouch in the lid here, and I can have a lot of traps of snares in this lid. So here's the snare we're gonna take a look at. There's a little trick to making good snares. This particular snare here is about a little bit more than 2 meters long. It shouldn't be shorter than that. It's a steel wire with some kind of a coating on. But the little trick comes here. You can see there's a coin. It's bent at an angle. I cannot really tell you what angle it is. You just have to try it out. There's 2 holes drilled in it. One for the loop. And one for the end here. And that's where you have your snare. The nice thing about this is that you can actually, it's very easy to adjust the size of the loop. It's very difficult to adjust the size of the loop on the snare without this little coin device. But the good thing is that when something comes in, it slides really easy down and it won't get back up very easy. You can see if I try to open my fingers, it doesn't go anywhere. And it just gets tighter and tighter. And finishes off the whatever you catch fast. So that's a little good trick on making snares. So over here behind me, it's a place that looks like, yeah, snowshoe hare could travel there. But most places look like that, but no, jokes aside, it looks like a place where they could travel. So this also seems to be like a few places it would be useful to block up the travel route. So so here's the general area we'll work with. We'll try to get the snowshoe hare to go this way or come from that way and over here. So we have to block up the sides and this and that. This is so how it looks like now. We'll come back when I'm done. So this is how it looks now. And over there we have the two snare spots. So we'll actually try and set the trap simulations here and here. And we could also make some over there. It's a big gamble always. Where they're gonna go. I mean, they could come here tonight, they could come here in 4 days. Who knows? So there and over there on these two small twigs, that's where we would put the snares. Snares would be attached to this tree and to that little sapling over there. Should be strong enough. These tracks there, they look like hawk or wild boar, whatever you wanna call them. Kaban, as they're called in Russian. Definitely looks like kaban. Snowshoe hare, more snowshoe hare. It's a good hunting ground, this place. So I've been sitting here trying to stay warm, had a ground pad with me of course and so on. I've been sitting from 3 to 4 hours before the sun went down, trying to see if there should pass a snowshoe hare or something. The black grouse only comes in the evening when the sun is already down, but the black grouse of course never sleeps in the same spot every night. Down here, over here, you can see some black grouse tracks. They're running around and eating this birch bark, the fine birch peelings. We have the trees over there. Birch is where they feed and the trees where they sleep. And a position down here. This bush here have been decimated pretty well by snowshoe hare. So not too far from the bush, you can see behind me where we just were. I have two other positions, one over there and one over there. See my ski and snowshoe tracks there. So here's a second position, and here we'll have a bit of a view in under here. And the Eva bush over there that we just looked at. And some more bushes around here, and the second shelter over there. So of course you can say these hunting positions, they are not classic hunting tactics, right? I already know that it's not very prosperous to just walk around on this snow, make a lot of noise. Doesn't matter if it's soft or hard. You will almost never see a snowshoe hare, and you will definitely not get close to the black grouse either. So my choice was, yeah, I make some positions. And I can sit and spend some time in them, and hopefully a snowshoe hare or something eatable will pass by. But it didn't. Here we have the third position under a small pine. And this is actually a black grouse that have been sitting here. The black grouse have been resting and eating here sometime after I was finished using this position and spend time in one of the others. That you can of course say is pretty frustrating. When you are out trying to get some food. The evening I was sitting in this position, I saw a crew of 5 or 6 black grouse out there just gliding in, and they landed up in the trees up there. Well, I of course knew that there was no way I could get to them. Black grouse, they always remind me of a squadron of fighter bombers or something. They just come gliding in with their wings open, not making a lot of sound, and low flight, very fast. They're tricky guys. So we are out checking the dummy traps that they set 2 days ago. You can see on my old track on the way to the next spot, snowshoe hare have been sitting and eating here. I don't know, let's look closer. It actually looks like we got something here. Here's where we were last time. And I blocked this area there. You can see some faint tracks there. Let's go over and look. And here. That's me over there. See right over there. See?
don't know if you can see it, but the snowshoe hare actually went through there. That is pretty awesome. See, there's another one in there. As I said, we could set up a trap out here.
We'll actually try and set the trap simulations here and here.
And you could also make some over there.
As you can see, this one have went in that direction. So if I had been serious last time and really wanted to catch something for real, with real snares, you can snare here. Then I would of course have blocked here as well. Maybe further down also. And it would be likely that we would have gotten something.
You can see where I blocked the area again. There, 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 and there. I made like a wall. And then, as I said, we wanted to put a loop there and a loop over there.
And it was not there last time. This was a completely clean spot. I hope we can see it on the footage. So chances are that I would have gotten two rabbits, or hopefully at least one of the two possible rabbits that where I would have set the real traps. But I don't like to I don't like to snare animals unless I really have to. I'm pretty all right with just training like this. I don't mind shooting them or something, but I don't want to put them through the misery of being strangled to death just because I'm out training. It's just me. Yeah, in hunting and trapping, a certain amount of luck is definitely needed. Skill can help you to reduce the amount of luck needed, but luck you will always need. And here I seem to have had that luck. I would just like to add one thing here, that if you're really out trapping one day for survival or preparing a trapping kit for survival, I would definitely not recommend only setting two or three traps. I'll say at least 8, 10 or 12 will be needed.
I plan to do more on this topic, and hopefully I will do it a lot better. And it was actually during making this video I realized I need some hunting cameras. And this is why I requested them. So I hope you like the video, and please check the links in the description. Go like me on Facebook. Like and share the video. I would appreciate that a lot. And until next time, get out and train. Get it done. And see you next time here in Russia.